And the number one seed, the defending Remax World Long Drive champion from Hertfordshire, England, Joe Miller.
Let's go across the pond with the defending champion. Tom Rinaldi reveals the story behind Joe Miller's remarkable rise to the top of long driving.
Joe Miller grew up in the shadow of London in the working class town of Barnet. He shares a modest home with his mother and older brother Daniel. The day starts with food. Lots of food.
It's a high protein diet, obviously. It's anywhere between 6 and 8 meals a day, between, say, 300 and 400 grams of protein.
From there, it's off to the gym.
He would go to my gym, it's called the Works Gym, which is in Barnet as well, 2 minutes from my house. Today it's going to be shoulders and arms, I think, today. The gym itself is quite a serious bodybuilding gym. It's not like a fancy type of place, you know what I mean?
Hello.
Hi, G. I'm going to train with my guy Tristan. He's an ex-page fighter as well.
With the power and stuff, it helps with Joe. And it obviously helps with me having someone as strong as him and competitive, and someone doing sports keeps me on my toes. Oh,
2 more. I never really train anything golf specific. I like to just train like a bodybuilder basically. I train quite hard and heavy.
From the gym, a short ride to the Shire, London, Joe's home golf club.
He's coming for a lesson. I don't have to see him first, I can hear him. There's noises coming from the range that you'll never hear anywhere else.
Rain or shine, Miller puts in countless hours on a range ill-suited for the world's longest driver.
250 yards to the trees, maybe. And then over the back of that is rugby fields. So, start throwing some bombs over to the rugby players. It's all good fun.
If he hits 100 balls a day, you lose 100 balls a day.
Probably about 10,000 balls a year. Cost the club a little bit of money, but they don't mind.
Joe's father, Dan, introduced him to the game at a young age.
I started hitting golf balls when I was about 4 years old, really. My dad gave me a little cut-down 4-iron. He used to smash it into cars and things like that, hit golf balls.
Dan was the first to see Joe's potential.
His dad always used to say, Mac, you should come and watch him. He's 10 times better than Tiger Woods.
I was a good stander. I was club champion at the age of 15. And it went on from there, really. Then eventually that sort of took me into long drive. And once long drive gets hold of you, it's hard to get out of long drive because it's so much fun.
After winning the 2005 European Championship, Miller made a splash at the 2008 Remax. Miller made it to the final night's quarterfinal round. Poor showing under the lights didn't discourage father or son.
When I got back from the Worlds 2008, he was awfully happy about my finish there. That was great. And then he started to feel full ill. And eventually, after scan after scan, we realized it was a brain tumor.
Dan Miller fought his cancer for 2 years before succumbing in the summer of 2010. Joe took the loss hard. He didn't enter the European qualifier and planned to skip the 2010 World Championship.
He told me he wasn't going to go. I said, you need to go. Your dad would like you to be there. And then he came to see me about 2 weeks beforehand and said, I made my mind up, I'm going.
It was an emotional rollercoaster sort of thing. It was up and down. And, I had to go out there and I had to do it for my dad.
As a non-exempt player, Joe battled through the last chance qualifier and then the elimination bracket to reach the quarterfinals again.
I think he put all that negative energy into something positive.
Once there, Miller dominated the competition. His strength.
Gigantic. This is gigantic.
Speed. And possibly some help from above.
Oh, we got a good kick to the left, and it's big.
That's the hot area. Will it stay there?
It is in, and it is long.
That might be the winning shot.
Huge.
To think that he was looking down on Joe on that day, and we saw that his ball took a massive leap left into the other, and we know that Danny was looking down, giving that a kick in bounds. And
he's probably down there, he's just nudged it in a little bit, and he gave me the helping hand I needed just to finish it off.
I was shouting, he done it for dad, he's won it for dad, he's made dad proud.
An amazing journey for Joe Miller last year. and he is in the driver's seat this year as the top seed.
Top four seeds, Miller, Walter, Hellstrom, Mansfield, all choosing to go second in this match play format.
In the first quarterfinal, Justin Moose versus Joe Miller. Moose to hit first.
Justin Moose starts off with a ground ball to shortstop. So certainly a lot of nerves here for the 25-year-old. Born in Pittsburgh, played college golf at Marion University of Pennsylvania. Qualified for the U.S. Open sectional twice. So he's got game, he's got a golf swing, and he's got lots of power at 6'3 and 225. Launches that one.
That's what we're looking for.
Big, nice little fade we talked about. The preferred ball flight would be that fade that you ride the wind
huge.
And get a bounce.
Huge.
That's going to go OB. He had about 435 worth of distance, but it peels off to the right. So here's his final ball in his first set of three.
I think the wind has shifted just a little bit more from the left to right than it was behind the players. And that should cost them 10, 15 yards of distance.
That one will be in bounds.
Yeah, that's down the left center, coming back toward the middle of the grid.
We haven't seen a lot of bounce in that side of the numbers. That'll settle in just under 400. So Justin Moose gets the nerves out and set number one.
Let's learn a little bit more about 6'4", 275-pound Joe Miller. He uses a 4-degree crank rage driver with a Fuji shaft to launch his mammoth drives.
Joe Miller's a player that, one, he creates unbelievable clubhead speed. So much with strength, his technique has improved over the last couple of years, and he just keeps hitting it longer and longer.
Slazenger ball track shows us Joe Miller's first ball.
Sniped way out of bounds left onto the practice area up that small ridge. So both players real quick with their first swings and pull it out of bounds.
Some of Joe's longest drives are sort of pull cuts, which under these conditions would be absolutely perfect.
That ball is hit left. That's going to be out of bounds too.
How much do you think the wind is in their mind, Art?
They've seen it gust all afternoon. The next thing you know, you start getting wrapped up. When's it going to gust? When should I take the club back? You should be here at this event going through your routine. And there's another quick hook from the top. And I don't know if he's trying to time the gust, but the wind will play big, big havoc on your head. Looking at Joe Miller's swing here, watch the left leg post. It's very square, and the hands flip through. Zero rotation with the hips. He's got to get off that right side.
Now Justin Moose's fifth ball.
Yeah! Yeah, there you go.
This could be the one. Get down that right side with a big bounce. Stay in. It will. It should get to 420, just shy. So he's working his way up, as Joe Miller says, good ball, man. Last ball for Justin Moose, a 25-year-old from Western Pennsylvania. One of three Keystone State participants among the final eight.
Push!
Moose got started in long driving, watching Carl Walter win back in 2002. He is in high school and said, that's pretty cool. Local guy wins. Maybe I should try that.
Art, let's go Adam Exmo on Moose's swing.
I love how Justin has that left arm across the chest. Look how tight that right arm is. Beautiful extension down and under. A swing that'll last in long drive.
Joe Miller, first three shots out of play. You didn't expect this. Quick swings, duck hooks, and he has got to time his jump right here and get a ball on the board over 420 or he's done.
He's a champion, though. You'd expect him to catch one good.
It's down the left center. That one will stay in the grid.
Wow.
I don't know how well he hit it.
He gets it. That's a winner.
422.
Huge shot right there. Huge clutch performance. That's a winner.
Great job, buddy.
So Joe Miller advances to the semifinals. He'll face either Carl Walter or Jamie Sidlowski. Their match is Sports Science coming up next.
2011 REMAX World Long Drive Championship, powered by Dick's Sporting Goods, is brought to you by REMAX. Outstanding agents, outstanding results. Golf Prime, the number one grip on tour, and Zero Friction, the number one tee for distance.